A year ago, spotted lanternflies seemed to be everywhere you looked, including on every single tree. And you might be thinking to yourself, are they gone this year? They're not. All you need to do is look up. Like here, on the top of this building. Spotted lanternflies aren't great flyers, but they are great climbers. And in an urban environment, they're gonna climb to the top of a skyscraper just like they would climb to the top of a tree.
Here at Kean University, we're trying to understand how urbanization is driving evolution.
If you go out to an apple farm right now, they're not nearly as easy to find as they are in, say, downtown New York City. The biggest reason is that the primary way that spotted lanternflies are moving is by people transporting them. The NJ transit lines are lined by the favorite host tree of the spotted lanternfly, called the Tree of Heaven. It's definitely helping to drive the spread of this species north and northeast. There's not much green space in cities to begin with. Spotted lanternflies could absolutely threaten the limited amount of green space that is in urban areas, particularly where there's really a limited amount of green space. So here's the really cool thing about an invasive species. Although our research isn't applied in terms of trying to understand how to control the spotted lanternfly, it provides us this amazing opportunity to observe urban evolution and test fundamental tenets of evolutionary theory in real time. We do have the potential in cities for there to be really detrimental effects on the limited amount of green space. It's paramount to us being able to preserve that green space for those people. So if you see a spotted lanternfly, feel free to squish it with your foot.